Hi everyone, my name is Mike Sinclair. I'm a principal researcher in the EPIC lab of Microsoft Research located in Redmond, Washington. Our function is multifold. A is to connect with our product folks and find out if they have any immediate technology needs that maybe they can't address or they don't have the skill sets. But the major function is to look ahead 1 year, 5 years, 20 years. Where do we see Microsoft products going? How do they serve the people? How do they serve the public? How do they increase quality of life, the fun in life, their productivity? Our lab specifically looks at HCI, human-computer interface. How do we more naturally communicate with computers? And that's both directions. You may think that looking at a screen is the computer's output and the keyboard is the computer's input, but it goes way beyond that. That's how we got interested in haptics. We don't realize it, but we touch everything. So we want to feel the texture of things, the compliance, and all the physical properties of a device or an object comes into play when you're in a virtual world. And as you know, in VR, you're wearing a head-mounted display, and you reach out, there's nothing out there other than maybe a re-embodiment of your hands, but you get this virtual world. Well, what's obviously missing is I can't reach out and touch it with my haptic sense or my sense of touch. And that's where we come into play. We have some amazing scientists, engineers, programmers, and designers that help us with augmenting that sense of touch. As part of the team, I have some amazing collaborators in scientists, researchers, developers, and designers. One of those is a fellow by the name of Dr. Eyal Ofek.
Hello, everyone. My name is Eyal Ofek. I'm a principal researcher at the Microsoft Research Lab in Redmond in a group called EPIC, which is Extended Perception, Interaction, and Cognition. And my interest in research is around virtual reality, augmented reality, and as a result, in rendering haptics, the touch sensing, for those experiences. And our vision looks at new areas where people might be using virtual reality and augmented reality in the future. And one of those areas is the work desk. We anticipate that people will use small virtual reality glasses as a replacement for monitors of today. So I could go anywhere I want, whether it is working from home or working while traveling. And instead of carrying a big laptop with a big screen, I just put on something that looks like regular glasses, and suddenly I see a large set of displays in front of me. The fact that we are augmenting their visual display give us a new opportunity to also augment their touch sense so that they could actually work with virtual objects on their work desk. People can actually touch and feel models, objects, terrains, remote patients, and other objects that they need to manipulate. And looking at this vision, we came out with different solutions. The first one is what looks like a small device with 9 actuators that can go up and down. Now, this is actually representing what we see as a haptic mouse. What do I mean by that? I could put my hand on the surface, and the surface could be representing some virtual object, maybe a terrain model of some area, maybe a patient on the table, maybe an animal that I pet, and so on. And as I move my hands around the table, the same way I do with the mouse, this surface will change its geometry to represent a larger object that I'm actually touching. This surface can go up and down. It could, each one of the actuators can change its geometry. Now, one important issue is generating the material for the top of the surface. On one hand, it should feel very rigid, like a solid object that I can touch. I don't want it to be like a balloon that if I touch, it's bending. On the other hand, it needs to be very flexible so that if one side is going down and one side goes up, it could stretch as a result. And a major part of the development was the development of this complex material. So this represents one way that we could feel haptics by moving with our hands.
It allows me to communicate at a distance in natural user interface, NUI, that's what we call it. And why should I have to conform to what only the computer has to offer, but why can't it be more natural like this? One of my colleagues, Eyal, said, why don't we put together kind of a game where a child can put their hand on here, scrub it around, and they are actually feeling a dinosaur. And maybe in their virtual reality head-mounted display, they actually see the dinosaur. They reach forward, they touch it, they're moving it around, they can feel it breathe, they can feel the skin ripple when you first touch them. So imagine how real that would be by adding haptics. Another application in the realm of haptics are what we call discoverable haptics. Notice that when I want to feel something, what haptics is all about, I only need to have things at my fingertips or my grasp or whatever I'm trying to touch. I don't need to worry about anything around that because I'm not touching it. I'm touching it with my hands. So with that in mind, why not have at your beck and call little robots that run around on your desk, and the system through cameras, other things, know where I'm about to reach. And if the robots are fast enough, the robot can run out there just in time for me to actually touch whatever I think I'm about to touch. And since the system knows what I should be able to touch, the robot then conforms to that shape, size, and position. And in this case, let's say I'm investigating a cityscape, and I come down on this roof of a house, and it's part of the gabled roof, and it's at this angle. So the robot would quickly go out there, orient itself, raise or lower this little platform, make sure it's at the right angle, at the right rotation, just in time for me to touch it. Wow, that's pretty cool. Take my hand away, and oh, I want to touch this building, and maybe it's at a different location. And maybe you need more than one, or a swarm of discoverable robots. And so, again, I don't need to cover the whole table with all these appurtenances, all these mechanics. I just need to be there just in time to be able to touch my hand or be there for my hand to touch it.
A final prototype that we want to show you is the X-rings. This object is represent the geometry that our hands grasp. Let's say that I'm in a virtual world and I may pick up a bottle, or I may pick up a cup to drink, or I may pick up a handle of a tool to work. Each one of them has different geometry, which nowadays, when people are using one type of controller in their hand, all feels the same. This device actually had a 3D shape display. It has rings that can grow wider or narrower, and do that extremely fast. So whenever I reach my hand to pick up an object, this could generate the shape of the object that I'm picking up, and I can actually, just by feeling it, can guess what was the object that I picked up, whether it was a pint of beer, or was that be the hammer. And we see that as a completion to touch object by encountering them, as we showed with the robots or the moving shape display mouse, this also enables us to pick object and feel them as different geometries. For more information about the future of haptics, please visit these links. Feel free to visit our Haptics Controllers and Rich Haptics for Mixed Reality website, or look at our latest announcement and Microsoft Research blog. You can also look at our latest publications. And feel free to contact us. We are happy to discuss this subject with you.
We hope these brief presentations of our devices and our view of haptics has inspired you. Hope to see a lot of you in research in the haptic topic in the future, and thank you and goodbye.
We have to actually rethink the entire AI stack.
What is reinforcement learning? Let's look at an interactive demo.
All our code is now open source.